Lights are out and they're away. It looks like a decent amount of wheel spin, and Schmidl actually already pressuring, although it looks like Klebas, with a fantastic start, is going to be the one that's piling the pressure onto Schmidl, but he can't be late enough onto the brakes. And there goes Schmidl up the inside into turn one, takes the lead of the race. Here comes the Acer car of Pelezny. He overtakes Klebas as well too, and here comes another, the other Acer car as well. Both the Acer cars managing to make their way through, and I have to say, Chris, this is a real shocking part here. Looks like everyone got through turn one cleanly.
It does look like it. There was a bit of wheel banging, a little bit of pushing going on. The eyes are side by side. And, there we go. Commentator goes.
Those guys, Kostulik, Thomas Prochazka, going for the soft compound tire. Speaking of Martin Stefanko, in 14th position, he's looking to move himself up into 13th position now. Oh, that's a scary moment into the first chicane as he closes up to the back of that Thrustmaster. And here we go with Klebas. And clearly he is feeling that he is the faster car compared to that Logitech of Kovacic. He's up the inside into the first chicane. Seen a few moves like that recently, and he becomes yet another. Oh, that's a big three-wide moment into the grass for the RPS car of Jan Seeker. He's got the inside line into Parabolica, but shooting around the outside goes the Avascar. He comes back at him at the exit of the Parabolica. Looks like he's just about got him. He's got the good exit out of Parabolica, but he won't have the slipstream, of course, here. Will he defend the inside line into the first chicane? Yes, he does. Seeker grabs that inside line. There again, three-wide on the rundown towards the first corner. So again, the Thrustmaster car of Pichotta trying to go around the outside, but this time there's a third car involved, and oh my goodness. Goodness gracious, this battle continues.
That's going to cost particularly Klebas a bit of momentum, but now is going to be the very big turning moment. There's a lot of bad markers there as well. Schmidl nailing himself to the inside line. That's Klebas for the race lead, but can he get the move done? Oh my God, was that impact between the two? I think it might have been lag, but Klebas has done it. Michael Schmidl has actually had the lead taken from him during a race. I'm not entirely certain that's happened at all, but certainly didn't happen in the the Formula class last season. I'm pretty sure of that, or if it did, I can't remember it. But Andre Klebas has actually taken the lead from Michael Schmidl.
Incredible. Absolutely incredible. Did Seeker get a good enough exit? He'll pick up the slipstream through Curva Grande on the run down towards the second chicane. Which way is he going to go? The Avascar does not defend the inside line, actually. Seeker up the inside, later onto the brakes, does take that position, moves himself up into 11th position. And and Frabish has gone for a bit of a spin as well, too. So that's going to lose him some time, but it doesn't look like it's going to lose him any positions. No, that's Corny behind in the spurt car, so that's not going to lose him any championship points. I can't even believe it, but it's really going to happen. Andre Klebas leading on the rundown towards Parabolica. He's got a couple cars ahead of him, but those are lap-down cars, and I don't think they're certainly not going to get in his way. And there it is, the confirmation. Andre Klebas has done it. He didn't take pole position. He didn't lead the race at the start. He had a five-second gap to overhaul.
So Andre Klebas there now has a confirmation with the fastest lap as well on the top spot. Schmidl 2, Blazik 3, Pelezny 4, Stefanko 5, excellent effort for him. Pichada 6, Zika 7, Frabish 8, Thomas Prochazka 9, and Anton Kesnik rounding out the top 10 for the VGP1s. Here are how the VGP2s stacked up. Soman Kovacic taking the win for the class and 40 seconds back to Pavel Rigel. Wow. We know Rigel's not slow.
No.
So that's an amazing gap there. Prochazka 3, Pichada 4.
We'll be back for round 12 from the replay studio. Thanks very much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.